Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new to the channel, I'm Meg. If you're coming back to watch me again, thank you. I just wanted to give you an update on the Fitbit Versa that I have had for a week now. Or by the time you're watching this, it'll be almost 2 weeks. Setting it up, how I feel about it right now, and how does it compare to my other two fitness trackers. Now, let's see. Where do I begin? Setting it up is easy in the sense that you do it over your phone, and it was pretty much a breeze. All I had to do was like every other every other fitness tracker is the same thing. You download an app, and then from the app you can control whatever it is that you want to put into your watch, except music. That was probably the most painful thing that I had to encounter because of this watch. It would have been so much easier if it just synced with my Apple iTunes or with my Spotify, but those two are not available in the App Store for this little watch here. They have a Deezer, which I have never heard of, and Pandora, who uses that? And there was one other one that just came out this week that also I've never heard of. Please, Fitbit, could you please just collaborate with Spotify or with Apple iTunes and just make it work with your Versa? Anyway, what I'd done was download some songs, created a playlist on my iTunes, which then, for some reason, when you connect this to your computer to put in the music, it actually works out. You have to download the app from the Mac OS. Well, in my case, it was a Mac, or whatever kind of computer that you're using, for you to be able to sync it with, or to download the music here. There is no way also for you to download, like for example, on your phone, you can move songs from your computer to your phone using a cable. This, no, it uses Wi-Fi or Bluetooth Wi-Fi. Yeah, so you're gonna have to have a very reliable Wi-Fi to be able to send through some songs. It can take up to 300. I think I've got 180 now in here, but it took me forever to figure out how to do it. And even after that, it also took a long time to transfer the songs. It was not quick. It took about 4 hours for me to be able to put in that 180 songs. So, and I started at 10, so I actually ended up waking up at 2 a.m. in the morning just to check if everything has downloaded. What? Yeah. Anyways, that's what happened. So I hated that part of it, but now that it works fine. It pairs well with my Empower Cheetah Bluetooth headphones, which I managed to also convince a friend of mine to buy. that worked out well. Now, in terms of use, I do like it. I like that you can change the face of the clock. I've got my wedding picture on it right now. You can put your own photo on it, or you can choose a face of a clock that is already pre-built. That's entirely up to you. Okay, now with regard to how accurate it is, I did say that I did try it with two of my other fitness tracker. One is the Jawbone Up and the Hello World, which I thought were actually not working or were dysfunctional, but it turned out that I just had to restart my phone because the Bluetooth had some issues on the phone. So when I restarted my phone, they all started working, and that was after I already bought the Fitbit Versa. Anyways, the most accurate, I would say, is actually the Jawbone. And I would say this because while this is actually very accurate, it's too sensitive with movement. And I know this because one day, and this is only by accident, I was still in bed in the morning, still contemplating on getting up and getting ready for work. And I looked at my watch, and it already said that I did 43 steps when I haven't been out of bed yet. So that was a little bit what? But I also did try like counting my steps, like walking to and fro, counting my steps, and then looking at the watch to see if it registered the same amount, and it did. But it feels like, or it seems like every time I move my hand, it counts that as a step, which is not good, because then, and I could tell that because both the Hello World and the Jawbone app registered about, let's say, 6,200 steps or 6,300 steps, and this was registering 7,600. Way too much. I wonder if there was a way to adjust the accuracy. If you guys know, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd appreciate that. Yeah, but it just was like too accurate. Obviously, this was still the best one in my opinion, because this actually tells time. My Jawbone up 3 doesn't. It's really just like a bracelet that I have to look at my phone to see like what time it is, how many steps I've taken, and all that stuff. Whereas this, because it's got like a proper watch, smartwatch, I can see everything on the screen of the watch. Now, the Hello World is probably the worst one because it didn't even register my sleep. And I wore the Fitbit on this one, and I wore the other two on this one. Spent the whole evening. I put it on at the same time. I put them all three at the same time after I showered in the evening. Slept with it, wore it the whole day, the next day, just to see. And I'll post here right now the results of that. So as you can see, in terms of accuracy, I would say that probably the Jawbone is still the best. And if I could adjust the accuracy of the Fitbit Versa, I would, because I just don't think that it's registering the right amount of steps. But in terms of heart rate, because like when I run in the treadmill, I do my heart rate on the actual treadmill, and I gauge it also on my watch, and they're pretty much the same. So everything else seems to be spot on except for the steps. It registers way too many steps, I think, which makes you believe that you've already done the steps that you needed to do for the day, when in actuality you haven't. So it's a little bit deceiving. Anyways, so far that's my update for you guys. I am still enjoying it, and I like the fact that I can listen to music and run without having to have my phone with me, which is really the major reason why I got this. And yeah. Oh, and also you can also log your food on here. I haven't actually tried that. I probably will, and update you further after I've used this for maybe 2 months to see. So far, in terms of battery as well, they advertise 4 days battery, but so far, maybe because I play music with it, it only lasts me about 3 days, and I have to charge it again. But so far, so good. I haven't tried the swimming or the water resistance. I probably won't. It's just, I'm just really not somebody who showers with jewelry on. Okay, so yeah. See, I'm sitting here. Before I sat down, it said that I had 129 steps left. And now it's saying I've got 48 steps left, and all because I've been waving my hand around. You know what I mean? So yeah, I'll keep you updated, guys. If you want me to do another one of these updates after 2 months and really give you an overview as well as my thoughts on whether it's worth the purchase, so far I think that it is. If I figure out how to maybe make it a little less motion sensitive, I probably will do that and see if that changes anything. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. And if you haven't already, subscribe and click on the notification bell so that you are notified when I have uploaded a video. I upload every Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays.